गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू टुडेज ऑनलाइन क्लास। द लास्ट क्लास आई हैव सेंट अ पीडीएफ ऑफ क्वेश्चन आंसर एंड ऑल्सो द डिस्कसिंग पार्ट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। नाउ टुडे आई विल डिस्कस द चैप्टर इन ब्रीफली, सो लेट्स गो टू द चैप्टर। दिस इज योर फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स, The Story of Village Palampur. The purpose of the story is to introduce some basic concepts relating to the production, and this we do through a story of a hypothetical village called Palampur. So Palampur is not a real village, it's a hypothetical village, and in this village the main activity of the people is farming. There are some other several activities like small manufacturing, dairy, transport, etc. This Palampur having some neighboring villages or towns, and in this village have about 450 families belongs to several different castes. The 80 upper caste family own the majority of land in the villages. The house, some of the quite large and made of brick with cement plus plastering. So the houses of these 80 families is very developed. Their houses made of bricks, cement, and the SC, that is called Dalits, comprise 1/3 of the population of the village, and they live in one corner of the village and in much smaller houses, some of which are of mud and straw. So in this village we can see the caste system also, and here the SC means Dalits, they live in a corner of the village. The village also electrified, and there have a electric tube well, you can see here. And there has two primary schools and one high school. So two primary schools and one high school. So there is a primary health center run by government and dispensary. So we can see that Palampur village is well developed village because it already electrified. They are having the irrigation facility with tube wells and two primary school, one high school, and we're having a primary health center which is run by government, and one private dispensary where the sick are treated. So let's go now. Organization of production. So in case of organization of production, the first requirement for production is first land, second labor, third is physical capital. So now I will discuss about these three requirements. The first requirement is land, the second requirement is labor, the third requirement is physical capital. In physical capital there are two types: fixed capital, working capital, and human capital also added here. Land, the first requirement is land,
and other natural resources such as water, forest, and mineral. So land is a first requirement. Second, labor. Some activities require fully qualified workers and highly educated workers to perform necessary tasks. And some activities require only workers who have physical capacity. So, in case of requirement of labor, some activities were having a need of a well-qualified workers, such as IT sector, some manufacturing industry, and some activities where we can only workers who have physically fit or physical capacity, having a good physical capacity. But in every activity, labor is vital. Physical capital, fixed capital, first. So I will discuss about the physical capital here. So here, in physical capital, one is fixed capital. Tools and machine range from a very simple tool such as farmer flag to sophisticated machine is called fixed capital. The very small machine to the sophisticated machine, all are fixed capital. Which are the sophisticated machines? Like generator, turbines, computers. Clear? Next. Physical capital, working capital. So I will discuss working capital. Production require variety of raw material like yarn used, weaver, and clay used by potter. So yarn used by weaver for making textile, and clay used by potter making some pots. Money is also required in production to make payment and buy other material. So if you want to buy raw material, if you want to buy product material, so you need money. So here money also play a role of working capital, and raw materials also play a role of working capital. So clear? Which are the working capital? So money and raw material are the working capital. How is land distributed in Palanpur? So I've already told you 450 families in Palanpur, where 450 families are landless. If 150 families of remaining families who own land, 240 families cultivated less than 2 hectare and land which does not give much profit. Remaining 60 families occupy large area above 10 hectare of land which gain much profit. So here some information about the land distributed. We can see from your book also. Now, will land sustain? Land being natural resource, so it is necessary to use very carefully in its use. So scientific reports have started that modern method have overused our natural resources. So green revolution is associated with the law of soil fertility due to increased use of chemical fertilizer. So I will discuss about the green revolution. What is green revolution? So in this way, we can sustain our land by this method. It's a green revolution. So what is green revolution? It is introduced during 1950 and 1960. Green revolution was the adoption of new technology to increase crop production worldwide. The new method employed were high yielding variety of seeds, uses of chemical fertilizers, irrigation techniques, machines for cultivation, etc. So it's a revolution in agriculture. So green revolution, when it introduced in our India, it adopt new technology, new method of employed high yielding variety of seeds and different types of chemical fertilizer. Now, who introduced green revolution in our India? So you can see here, green revolution started in India in 1965 with the help of scientist M.S. Swaminathan. So always remember it, M.S. Swaminathan, who is also known as father of green revolution. So who is the father of green revolution? M.S. Swaminathan. It was a great help to recently independent India after the British rules. So it is a great help for our India after independence. How is land distributed? I have already told. Land is fixed. Yes, land is fixed. Farming is main activity in Palampur, we know 75% people are working in the field and farmer, but there is constant rise in population. So land is fixed, but population is rising. So the waste land are converted to the cultivated land. So due to supply more crops to fulfill the needs of the people of that village, now there exists no land to convert to cultivated land. So already land converted to cultivated land. So now they are having no land to convert to cultivated land. So land is fixed. Now types of some non-farming activities. So non-farming activities are dairy, small scale manufacturing, shopkeepers, transport, etc. Dairy farm. Dairy is common activity of people of non-farming category. The milk and other dairy products can be sold at neighboring cities and towns at good profit. And this is main occupation for people in rainy season. So during rainy season, it's main occupation. Small scale manufacture. At present, less than 50 families are engaged in manufacturing. In Falampur, manufacturing involves very simple products methods, and these are done with help of family members. So there are some small scale manufacturing, like some handicraft work, some power looms, like some food processing, shopkeepers. So people involved in trade are not many in Palampur. So there are very less person who involved in this activity. The traders of Palampur are shopkeepers. We can see small general store which is sell a whole range of rice, wheat, sugar, tea, oil, biscuits, notebook, batteries, pen, pencil. So we know every village there have some one or two shop where you collect your necessary item like rice, wheat, oil, biscuits, etc. So some less person there belongs to this type of activities in Palampur. Now, transport fast developing sector. So as you know, in Palampur, it's well connected by roadway with cities and villages. There are variety of vehicles in Palampur. There are riksha, tongas, jeeps, tractors, trucks, traditional bullock carts, etc. The ferry people and goods to one place to another place. The ferry people and goods to one place to another. So in this way, I have completed your first chapter of economics in briefly. And for further details, you just read your book and you can collect some extra knowledge from this chapter. And I have already sent the question answer of this chapter. If any queries regarding this chapter, you can put your question in query option, and next video you'll get the NCERT question answer. Thank you and have a nice day.